good times. There's gonna be good times, good times.
I know there's gonna be
work every day till we meet ends.
Greatness, it doesn't just happen. It's crafted by the hands of hard work through personal practice. To be all you can be, that desire lies within the hearts of men. And once it is realized, a star has arrived. When you'll see it rise, it's just a matter of time. There's no market size that can dim your shine. KD lifted OKC in ways reminiscent of LeBron. All hail King James, Mr. Two Rings. Now it's up to Uncle Drew to fill his shoes and reign. Paul George took the world by storm from the platforms of the playoffs. An all-star night is proof that hard work pays off. No days off for the young and the restless, nor the wise and battle-tested. Timmy D and Dirty Dirk still shooting it out in the Wild Wild Western. Oh, this year, we in for a ride. K-Love is back to reprise a city deprived of their friend who could power his way to the rim and leave defenders grim with shots from the outside, trying to lead his team like Flash in 06 when he won his first chip. Now, D-Way is going for four. Meanwhile, Memphis brought back Mike the Shoe Miller in hopes to stretch the floor, and D-Town locked down J Smoove and Doobie Doo to prepare the Bad Boys for war. It's not a matter of if, but a matter of when. We'll look up and see soaring out of the troughs the Hawks and the Pelicans with all the talent they're bringing in. Future's looking bright like candles. Orlando may get some magic from Oladipo. Out west, High Griffinish is still leaving players steamrolled. Let's call them Lob City Pancake Dunks. The Bucks made a change at coach and MJ crowned Steve Clifford. Hornacek is back to the quest and the Clips got Doc Rivers. But just remember, being a playoff team doesn't mean you're a contender. The quest to be great can never stop. From yay high ball players to champions at the top. It's all in what you believe. Everyone needs a dream and never quit. In one shot, we witness fortunes flip. Sugar Ray, game six. Swish. Through the NBA, the basketball gods have been gracious by allowing us to see on full display the one thing that's in all of us, greatness.
Yo, welcome to the channel. And yeah, that guy cooked, I'm not gonna lie. Watching that was actually fun. And going back 10 years, man. Damn, it's been a while. 10 years ago, we were playing 2K, the first park. Man, life changes so fast, man. And yeah, the 2014 Lucas. NBA season. The Miami Heat had LeBron, the Spurs had their final dance, Dirk was actually really good, and a lot of the guys we saw as legends are all retired now.
I went fresh.
No way.
You know, going back to 2014 and watching all these highlights and trying to research all the players who played so well that year, it just makes you wonder how much the league has changed and looks completely different. But now let's sink our teeth into the video and talk about the actual season. So let's start off with the Eastern Conference. Now, in the East, we had the first place Pacers led by Paul George and the crew. If y'all remember, this was the year when Roy Hibbert was in DPOY conversation.
Huh?
Oh man, what action?
And yeah, this was peak Pacers basketball. And man, I'm not gonna lie, this was the year when we saw peak Paul George. His team was playing well. The Pacers were ready in the playoffs, and they actually put up a good fight against the Heat. And if y'all remember, that Birdman dunk.
Here comes George, got the step, and Spurs one move, and counts on the foul! He would beat LeBron James with that quick step. A sensational move by Paul George.
We are seeing a superstar in the making here with Paul George. Gets the step on LeBron James. The Birdman is just a little bit late, rotating over, and click, click. Birdman, this is your Kodak moment.
That was ridiculous.
In second place, we have the Miami Heat, obviously. And this team, man, I remember, I used to think they were the Avengers, the Invincibles, you can call them the Dream Team, the Villains. There's so many words you can use for this team because they had just came off of back-to-back championships. Now, at the time, this team was so stacked in terms of talent because, let's think about it. In 2018, the Cavs made the finals with LeBron and J.R. Smith being his second scoring option.
Talking to him after the play, what's your reaction to it? What's your version?
What do you mean, what's my version?
LeBron, what you doing? That's my stuff! Why did you hold the ball?
Just let that sink in. So we're talking about prime LeBron with Dwayne Wade, which is why they won two championships, and they were looking to three-peat this year. Then we're going to head up north, and you all know the Raptors were starting to build an identity, and we were playing with DeMar and Lowry. If y'all remember, we had great regular seasons, but Toronto never got it done in the playoffs, which has always been our issue. Now going into fourth place, we had the no-knees Derrick Rose-led Chicago Bulls. I'm sorry, I did not mean to make that reference, but this team was just old, aging. A lot of the players were starting to decline, and especially Derrick Rose, if he was not the peak engine form he was in that MVP season, the Bulls were doomed either way. But they had one promising star on the way, and his name was Jimmy Butler. And in fifth, I really don't gotta say anything, but it was Washington with John Wall. Now in the sixth position, we had the Brooklyn Nets. Now if y'all remember, this team was old, aging, and they just traded away their entire future for KG, Paul Pierce, and Jason Terry. All a bunch of old heads were aging and out of shape. Not KG, but you get my point. This was the issue with this team, and they never really meshed. And as we know, they got bounced in the playoffs. But it's pretty sad to think that what future the Brooklyn Nets could have had if they didn't make this trade. And in seventh place, we have the Charlotte Hornets. You can probably call them the Bobcats because I think they're still called that. But this team was actually pretty solid because they had a young, up-and-coming Kemba, and they had Al Jefferson. And if you play 2K, you know that Al Jefferson is no joke.
Oh my god! Wow!
And in 8th, we had the Hawks. Now the Hawks were obviously very, very mid, but they finished 30-44. And we know that in 2015, they actually have a great season where they finished first. And yeah, this was before the play-in, so I obviously won't talk about the number 9 or 10 seed. But most of the bottom feeder teams were either trying to tank for a top pick. Look at the bottom feeders, there's only one team that had a crazy rebound. As we all know, the Milwaukee Bucks, they had Giannis. Now Giannis was basically in the lab at this time, and he grew from becoming a player who no one knew about to the MVP we saw all these years. And as an honorable mention, I can't forget about him, but Kyrie Irving was cooking with the Cavs. This was the year when we saw that Kyrie can be a pivotal building stone for the Cavs. And as we all know, a year after this, LeBron would say, "I'm coming back home."
Welcome home, LeBron.
And so that's basically it for the East. I could add more, but I mean, the East, as we all know, was the weaker conference. Now you may be wondering, where's the West? I'm not gonna do the West because I wanna see if y'all actually wanna see it.
Oh, brother, this guy stinks!
So, I'm gonna make this a two-part video. I know, don't go into the comments now. I know some dude's really angry right now, it's like,
nah, dog, you gotta be trolling right now. Finish the damn video.
But I want to see if you guys want to see it for real. So if this video gets to 5 likes, part 2 will be released. So yeah, that's all for this video for now. And I hope you liked it. I hope it showed you how different the NBA was and all the great memories 2013-2014 was compared to what it is now. So yeah, if you liked the video, leave a like, sub to the channel. I know this is my first video. I hope you liked it. And yeah, that's basically it. James Nesmith is the GOAT. And stay safe. Peace.